Welcome once again to Seven Coding Academy. In this tutorial, I want to teach you how you can use OBS Studio for recording. For us to kickstart it, let's not waste time. Go straight to Google. When you get to Google, type OBS. OBS. And to Google, type OBS. Then immediately to open obsproject.com. Click on obsproject.com. Click on obsproject.com. Now, by default, you see there is Windows, there is Mac, there is Linux. But by default, Windows already pre-installed for you to use. If you are using a Windows with like me, you can click on Windows. If you are using Mac, you go to Mac. But since I'm using Windows, I will not waste time, so I click on Windows. So you click on Windows. The beauty of OBS is that it's a free software. It's a free source. You don't pay for it. And it records in video very, very well. Now let's hold on a little for it to get, you can see it, it's installed, let it download first, so we can continue from there. So while it's downloading, I'll be talking. OBS has a lot of advantage because it's a free software, as I said, and it's an open source. So with OBS, you can record anything, video anything. I will show you how this is done in a jiffy. Let it just need downloading, still downloading, because it's true. And please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I'm giving me this lecture for free. The only thing you can give me back to subscribe to my channel. And you have an advantage. Subscribe to my channel. Once I release videos like this, you'll be the first. YouTube will notify you, and you can easily go and watch it and learn. And if you also have suggestions, if you also have better ideas, kindly bring it. I like people share information. That is why I was able to bring up myself to teach freely anything that I learn. Okay. It's still downloading, so that's why I'm talking. Once it's downloading, we'll continue our work and we'll progress. So let's watch. It's almost done. It's almost done. It's almost done. You can see my mouse. Let me take it aside. See that it's almost done. It's almost done. So we are through. Click on it. Click on it and click open. Welcome to OBS Studio. Click next. Click next. Of course, they have some license agreement. If you have time, you can read through it. Don't have time like me, you continue. But don't fail to agree first. You must agree to the license agreement. And once you agree, you click next. This is where they are going to put it, program file OBS Studio. I'm okay with this, but if I'm okay with this, you can click on browse and decide where you want your OBS Studio to be. Okay, but I'm okay with this, I will click on install right away. It's installing. Let the installation finish, I will continue. Once the installation is true, we'll continue. Once it's true, you click on finish. Supposed to be it, okay. Just hope it appears for us to see it. Yeah, our OBS Studio has appeared. If you check, there's some button there. Yes, it's optimized for streaming. Recording is secondary. Third one says optimized just for recording. I will not be streaming. And the last one say I will only be using the video camera. You can choose any of them, but since we are actually running lesson now on recording, so I will choose optimize just for recording. I will not be streaming, so click there and then click next. You see what it's telling you right now? It says specify the video setting you would like to use. Best camera resolution. This position that OBS has choose for, based on my system, so I will go with it. But if you don't want to go with it, you can, from here, you make your selection, okay? Then for the EPS too, you can make your selection from here. But I am okay with this, so I will go with this. Let's click on next. So this is what they are telling you now. Testing complete. So the programmer is determined that this estimated setting are ID for you, which I believe is okay for me, so I will go with it. So the next thing to do is to come down and click on apply settings. For the first time now, you see if you are using OBS Studio, you see what is appearing here. So sometimes you may get confused, may not know what to do now because of the option. But you don't worry, if you check, everything is working. The desktop audio is here, the auxiliary audio is here, both of them are working. It's like the desktop audio is not working, auxiliary audio is working. Okay, let's see how it goes. But at least you see that it's working. So it's working. So let's now come over here to source. You see source, and that source you choose, click on source. If you check on the source, you see this application audio capture, audio input capture, audio output capture, color sources, display capture, game capture, for those who want to, who are into game. But yeah, we talk about display capture. To capture, you want to show your stream, so click on display capture and that'll be shown there. Then so click on display capture. Now for this display capture, you can decide to change the name, but let's leave it like this for now. But the more you have more work, you can change the name. So click on OK. Now everything has come up. You can see all everything, we are ready. The stream is being recorded, it's ready to start recording. So but before we do, let's go to settings and set some things up. So come here, click on file and click on settings. General setting, language, theme, those ones are okay. But if you want to change it, you can change it. So but for me, this is okay. So I'm not changing anything. So let's go to output mode. Under output mode, you see your sample. For this sample, let's check it to advanced side. I will say do one or two things on it then. Now for the sample type, for the advanced type, you come over here, the Twitch, everything is okay, so I'm not changing anything here. It is okay. But let's go to the recording type. So for the recording type, you can generate a file name for your space, but I don't want to generate that. Encoding, you can also change the encoding if you want to. You can choose any of the encoding style you want, but I think this should be okay. Let's use the default, but if you don't like the default, you can choose any of the encoding screen, like 264 is okay as well. So you choose anyone. Then for custom user setting, you can also put it if you want to, but I think I'm okay with this. So at least since the setting is okay by me, we should move on to the next one. Those sometimes if you want, you can change your bitrate if the video is not doing well. But let's go to audio. For audio, the 160 is okay, everything is okay, the paper fat is okay. So I'm not work too much on that. It's 160, but it can go 44, it can go 48. For example, if you scroll here on your audio setting, you can change it to the one you like. But I think 160 is okay, so I'll go with 160, but you can change it if you want to. For recording on that browser, you can decide how you want it, but this is okay. If you want browser, you can click on it, and but I like it on my video. But if you don't want, you can click on browser and change it to the one you like. Maybe if you want to be on your desktop or anywhere, you can change. But let's leave that default. Default is okay by me. So let's click on apply and then click on OK. And now we are back, we are done with that. So if let's just record and see if all goes smoothly. But I still want to do one thing on settings. This remote recording, if you go to settings under video, I want to do one thing. Let me check that. Something I want to do that will help us. Under video. So if you come over here, this one is okay. So I'm okay by it. The 30 is okay. So I'm not going to do any major changes right there. You know, the dance is okay. Dance is okay. The command 35 is okay. So I'm not going to do much work there. But go to advanced. It's okay. This is MVBit is okay. So I just want to check to make sure everything is okay before we go ahead and record. Okay. So the other directory, the yes everything is okay. So since it's okay, you click on okay to make sure that everything is okay. Now let's now come over here, and then for you to start, you go to controls. If you see control here, it says start streaming, start recording, start video camera, but we are doing recording. So what we do is we're going to click on start recording so that we can record. Let's click on start recording. And now that it has started recording, if you now scroll down, you see that to record this, you see everything will be recorded for us to see. So you're seeing the way the whole thing is recorded. When it's recording, you check all your scene, your scene is okay. Don't worry, the next class I will teach you how you can work on your scene, how you can put your webcam and all that, you know, because even as it's recording, you can still be changing some things, adding some things, even as it's recording. So in the next class, I'll teach you that. But this is how it works. This is your OBS Studio. Once you finish recording your stream, you now click on stop recording. And if you want to stop recording, you can now listen to it and see what you've recorded. Okay, so for you to listen to it, you go to your video, you go to your video file. From videos, you will see it, then you click it and watch all that you've recorded. Are you following me? So this is how you can install OBS Studio and work with it. Let's go to the next class. I will now show you how you can check all that has been recorded right now. Thank you so much.